Hi guys, so I wanted to make a quick video today because there are a lot of discussions going around BookTube right now about BookTube culture, things like that, and there's one specific thing I really wanted to talk about that's like super important. I don't know a lot about the things that are being talked about other than what's I see happening in some of the discussion videos. A lot of the things that people are talking about, I personally have not experienced firsthand, so I can't really speak on a lot of these topics. But there's one thing I saw mentioned in a video where someone said that there are BookTubers who are doing sponsored content or they're getting books for free from publishers and they're not disclosing that information. And this is not okay. I mean, there's the idea that you're being deceptive to your audience if you don't disclose that information, like that's one thing, but this is not okay on a separate level because it's also illegal to do that. One thing about our community is a lot of the people who watch BookTube and kind of participate in BookTube are on the younger side, so I really thought it was important to make this video because I realize a lot of you guys aren't old enough to really know a lot about media law and disclosures and things like that. So I thought it was super important that I make a video talking about this because this is something that could potentially get you into trouble without you even realizing you are doing anything wrong. And also, all the information that I'll be talking about is based on American or US law because I'm don't live in any other countries or I've never lived in another country, so I'm not really aware of how this works in other countries. Also, I'm not a lawyer. The vast majority of the information I'm going to be talking about in here are things that I've learned either through my media law classes or things that I've just learned about based on articles and things like that. I will put resources down in the description below so you guys can read up on this further. I'm just going to be talking about the things that would pertain very specifically to BookTubers, but this kind of just pertains to anyone who does any sort of reviews or gets things for free. So the Federal Trade Commission, or the FTC, is this federal agency that in America, their job is to basically oversee any sort of consumer-related policy, and they're supposed to basically provide consumer protection. So one of their big things is sort of like disclosure information. So if anyone receives something for free and then posts about it, whether it's a review online, like on Amazon or on their blog, or even just posts about it on their Facebook or Twitter feed or anything like that, you have to disclose that information that you've received that product for free from the company. The exceptions to this rule is like if you got it for free because of like a coupon, but if you got it from someone who like works at the company, you have to disclose that information. Basically, what you have to do is if you receive a book from a publisher, you have to disclose that the publisher gave you that book, and you can't also hide the disclosure in any way. They made an update to their law in 2013, so you have to make sure that it's clearly stated somewhere, whether it be you saying it vocally at the top of your video or putting it at the top of the description of the video itself. One thing that people used to do is they would like kind of hide the information either towards the ends of their blog posts, or they would put it in really small fonts, or they would put it like at the absolute bottom of their descriptions and when there's a bunch of text above it so you wouldn't most likely see it ever. But the FTC actually recently revised their standards so that way it says like it has to be in a prominent place and it has to be very clearly stated. Also, you can't hide it, you can't try to disguise it anyway, you have to have it pretty clearly stated. If you don't have it clearly stated and the Federal Trade Commission finds out, you can get fined up to like $11,000, I think, or you could get sued by your viewers. Technically, if it's found out that you've made sponsored content and you haven't disclosed that it's sponsored. Just for the record, I don't have a problem with sponsored content or bloggers or any sort of reviewers getting free content or anything like that in exchange for an honest review. I think that's totally fine as long as the reviewer actually is providing an honest review, and that's up to you to provide that sort of trust or to build that sort of trust within your own audience. So what you should do is basically if you are making a video and you have received either a product or you've gained something from a publisher to help make that video, you need to disclose that information very clearly, either by saying it at the beginning of the video or by putting text in the video that says it, or by putting text at the top of your description, preferably above that little break that happens, because one of the FTC's new big things is the fact that it has to be very clearly labeled. So if it's buried underneath a bunch of other links, then there is going to be a potential problem there. And it doesn't really require a lot. All you have to say is, I received this book from a publisher for a honest review or something along those lines, or put in the description, I received this book for free from the publisher, but this is my honest opinion anyways. Like, and not only is it a legal requirement, but it also just shows that you are honest with your own audience and that they can trust you. If I found out that one of my favorite YouTubers was doing reviews and they weren't disclosing that they were getting the products for free, or if there's like a booktuber I really loved and they were getting a bunch of free stuff and they never said anything about it, I probably would unsubscribe to them, and I would probably not trust any review that they put up because they were dishonest with me about that. So what makes it so they wouldn't be dishonest with me about other things? But really, in the end, the reason why I'm making this video is because I want to make sure all of you booktubers out there are being legal in the things that you're doing. I realize that YouTube and the internet in general is a very new place, especially when it comes to legal rights and things like that. So I want to make sure that when you guys are creating content, that you are doing it legally and you guys won't get into any trouble and you won't do something wrong without realizing that you're doing it and things like that. So this is me being the adult in the room and making sure that you guys are all safe and sound. If you have any questions about any of these things, feel free to leave a comment down below. Again, I've left some links in the description so you guys can read up on stuff on your own. But again, I'm not a lawyer, but I'll try my best to try to help find answers for you. And again, I don't know how this really works in other countries, what laws other countries have in terms of these things, but at least in the United States, this is how it all works. So yeah, that's all I have for now. Thanks for watching.